If you like to exclude files and folders from your WKC backup, you can have a look in the WKC wiki. There's an entry called include exclude patterns, and I will show you the simple basics how you can exclude, for example, a single file or a single folder. Please stick to the explanation in the wiki and don't stick to my video if you like to use this feature. This is just a demonstration how easy it is. I will scroll a bit down and here is the regular expression matching, and I will use this method for demonstration purposes. I am now in my test folder and I will list all files. And as you can see here, this is the root folder of my WKC backup. This can be recognized at the .wkc folder. And as you can see here, I have an important and an unimportant file, and I did a typo here, so I correct this. Nevertheless, we have two files here. One file should be backupped, the other one not. And guess what? We use the unimportant file to be excluded from this backup. So how to do this? I change to the .wkc folder. I create a file called filters and I add a line and I start this line with E colon. E stands for exclude in this case. I paste the file name here and I save this file. What to do next? So I go back to the root folder for this backup and I start the backup. You can now see that one include exclude pattern has been loaded. So hopefully this worked. To verify now that everything worked fine, I check again the files and the folder structure. I delete both files here and I will now start a restore for revision 2. What should happen now? The unimportant file should not be restored, only the important file should be restored. Let's check. And as you can see, just the important file has been restored. So that's pretty all, but it can get more complicated, so please check out the wiki, which is linked in the video description below.